here at ESTEC at ETS to looking for Hera spacecraft, which is preparing for the thermal vacuum testing. The whole mission started with a study seeing if it is even possible to deflect any asteroids that would be a threat to Earth. NASA did the first satellite, which went to Dimorphos and on purpose crashed into the asteroid. And we know already by the NASA DART mission that it is possible to change the orbit of the moon of the asteroid. Hera is going now to see that how deep the impact was. Well, is there a big crater, a small crater, or what size of a crater is? So that the scientists in one day, in case some far, far away day, there will be any asteroid that would be a threat to Earth, that we could have a mechanism how to deflect them away. Hera is really is going there and see the crime scene, what happened there. I do like that impression that it is like a crime scene investigator. Here we have the thrusters. The function of the thrusters is that while we are traveling towards the asteroid, that if we see that our position is drifting somewhere away from the course we want to go, the thrusters will be fired. So depending where we want to go, so either this one or that one over there, they will be fired. If we go a bit here, we call this asteroid deck because this will be the one facing towards the asteroid. So what we have here is on the left-hand side, those which are covered currently with these round white things, those are the asteroid framing cameras. And they are focusing all the time to the asteroids. Main focus is that, okay, we know that where the asteroids are and we are still going on the right course. Then in between these asteroid framing cameras, there is the Japanese instrument called TIRI, which is thermal infrared imager. So once we get to the asteroid, that will take the first thermal infrared images of the surface, and we will see there the impact which are darted. So we will see how deep is it, or is it deep at all. So that's what we will find out with that camera. This one is the hyperscout, so that's also a camera that takes images. In the middle, you will see the planetary altimeter. So once we come closer to the asteroid, one thing what we will try out is to have automatic navigation. And that will be used to measure the distance to the asteroid. In a corner there, there is a spacecraft monitoring unit. That's also a camera. We'll also collect the data of the dust, which was left by a DART impact. It will also collect information of the mass, or estimate of the mass, what is the mass now after the impact. Behind these silver squares, there are two CubeSats called Juventus and Milani. They will be released, and those can go even closer to the asteroid to collect more information, for example, of the dust particles, what are there, what is composed of the dust particles. One of them is also equipped with a gravimeter, so CubeSat will land on the asteroid and then measure the gravitation. It's really important that we will have all the information, because of course we don't want to have the same fate that the dinosaurs had. This one is now about to go to space. Well, this year in October we will launch. So we have already done the mechanical testing. So the vibration facilities we did earlier last year. And then we also did the acoustics test. And now we are preparing Hera to go for the thermal vacuum test. And that's why you see it now open, because we are adding some thermocouples. Of course, we have done testing on the equipment levels, but now when all the system comes together, that the whole system does survive the launch environment and the vacuum and, of course, thermal changes. I'm the last PA to sign off or give the permission to go ahead with all the activities which will happen in SpaceX. And also after encapsulation with the common activities with them, then I'm the last one that said that yes, now we can go. And of course, it's a lot of responsibility. And in every launch, there's or launch campaign, there's always surprises. It doesn't matter how many launch campaigns you go through, there's always something that you didn't think of. we don't have so much information or so much experience of the launching with SpaceX. So I'm expecting some surprises also there. I'm most excited to see, of course, the launch. Everything's ready to go, and I'm really confident that we will be in good hands.